PathPilot Quick Tips Robot Edition. So today I'm going to give you a quick overview of using the conversational screens to create a robot program. We're just going to throw some commands into a robot program. I might show you how to reorder them, how to move them around, add and delete them. And then when we're all done, we'll take a look at the Python that gets created for you by these conversational screens. That Python is the robot programming language, and it's the code that the robot uses when it's doing its thing. So, we'll start just by going to the conversational screen. The very first tab is the Move tab. I'm going to add, we'll add these waypoints. We'll add moves to these waypoints to the program. Now, we'll cover the whole Move tab and waypoints in depth in other quick tip videos, but for now, I just added four different moves to a robot program. The Set tab, we can set a digital output to go low. We'll add that one, and then let's go ahead and we'll change it. We'll add it, now it'll go high, right? But maybe I don't want that to happen like boom, boom. Maybe I want to sleep a little bit in between that. So let's add a sleep command in here for 2 seconds. I'll add that to the program. And as I mentioned, I want these things to happen, you know, not low, high, sleep. I want it to be go low and then sleep for 2 seconds. So I'll come over here and we'll just move that command up a little bit. Another screen, we'll go ahead and put this in, notification. Let's say I want to put a notification into the operator that says, hello, robot fans. If I wanted to, if I had an image, if I had taken a photo of a setup I want to remember, I could put the image in here too. But for now, I'm just going to add this little notification, add it to the program. We could go on and do more stuff. I've got PathPilot 1100MX set up here next to the robot, and we could give it arbitrary MDI commands or tell it to start its cycle, but we'll cover that in another quick tip video. For now, I've got this program. I can go ahead and save it. Look here, it warns us. It says, look, your command to set that digital output low or high doesn't have a name. So I can, it's a warning. It'll run just fine without it. I could abort this, so I could go back in here and we could actually correct it. We could correct it by naming the digital output DIO1. Or we could call it Air Blast, whatever we want. And then this will be a nice little tutorial here on how to remove stuff. So let me remove these two changes to get the digital output high and low. We'll go back to the set screen. Now it actually has a name, so we're not going to get that warning. We'll add that there. We'll go ahead and make it high. We'll add that there. And let's reorder these a bit. Look good. Save it. Test for quick tip video. All right. I mean, I can go ahead and run this program. It's nothing fancy, right? It's just going to move to those waypoints. It's going to set that digital output high, then it's going to move again, it's going to move again, it'll sleep for 2 seconds, it'll set the digital output low, and then it gives us our notification. Very easy stuff to do. Let's go ahead and take a look at the program, though, real quick. And just like in PathPilot CNC, you can expand the MDI line, which gives you a view of this. All this here is regular old Python. And in fact, if we wanted to over in, we could go ahead and edit this program. And we can just see here that this is it's regular Python. So not everybody's familiar with Python, but I can tell you it's a much easier language to learn than G-code, and there are a lot more tutorials about Python out there on the interweb than there are for G-code. So it should be pretty easy for most people who don't already know Python to get going with it. And of course, like everything else that Tormach does, we're going to help you understand it if you don't know how to write any Python code yourself. Just like in our CNC world, if you don't know G-code, you can still use a milling machine. If you don't know how to write Python, you can certainly still use the robot. Thank you very much for watching.